What did you play for as a kid?
When I was a young boy, when I was my early teens, I played for Fargo National Boys Club. Then I went to Glasgow Amateurs when I was a young boy, when I was 15. And then when I was 16, I turned professional to go with Dumbarton. I spent 4 years at Dumbarton, and then when I was 20, I went to Glasgow Celtic.
So Dumbarton was your first senior club?
Dumbarton was my first senior club. I went there as an apprentice football player. Used to do all the odd jobs round about the stadium before the senior players came in to play football every morning. We used to clean the boots and make sure all their strips were hanging up and were all neat and tidy for them.
So what other clubs have you played for, apart from Dumbarton and Celtic?
After Celtic, I went to play for Borussia Dortmund, Germany. I played there for nearly 4 years. I came back to Scotland as assistant manager and player for Hibernian. I played with Hibs for 3 years, and I went back to Dumbarton as manager. And I played at Dumbarton again as player manager, then I went on to be the manager of Partick Thistle, and then I went on to be the assistant manager of Celtic.
So what was your favourite club?
I might say they were all favourites to me, and every week when I look at the results, I always check my all the teams I played for, Dumbarton, Celtic, Borussia Dortmund, Hibs, Partick Thistle. That's the side I want to see doing well. So I think different ages at different clubs meant different things to you. When you're a young boy in Dumbarton and you're learning how to play football at a top level, you're listening to the managers, you're listening to the experienced players, then you get moved to Celtic. You're part of a great side because I'm in the championships for 9 years, then when I moved to Germany. Again, it was a fantastic club with a big support. You're out there trying to win trophies and being lucky enough to win two trophies. And then when you come back to Hibs, again, a club which he has to win a cup with Hibs. It was just a fantastic occasion. So I think I wouldn't pick one out. They're my teams always look first for the race.
So how many caps have you had for Scotland?
I've got 20 caps for Scotland. I was fortunate enough to play my country. It's, I think, one of the best things that can ever happen to any football player. Is to play for your country. My first cap was against England at Hampden. We beat them 1-0. So Richard Gough headed goal. So it was a fantastic day out. That was my first cap for Scotland and one of the proudest moments in my football life.
So what was the most embarrassing moment of your career then?
Embarrassing moments, that's a difficult one. I've been lucky enough, I've not had any embarrassing moments. I've had disappointing moments when we've lost important games or lost any game. They're disappointing, but I don't think there's any embarrassment. I don't think I fell downstairs or tripped over my shoelace or anything on the park. I think I was fairly lucky that way because that's something we tried to stay away from and get involved in something people can have a wee laugh at later on.
So who did you support as a young lad?
I supported the team I was playing. So my first team was the Second Mogai Boys Brigade, and that was the first team I supported.
Who was your favourite idol footballer as a child?
When I was a child, I think when I got into football a wee bit, one of my favourite players was Johan Cruyff. He was a Dutch player. Played for Holland, one of the fantastic all-round football players, one of the great football players. He was one when I was 13, 14 years of age. I was the one player I looked at, and I thought he was one of my favourites.
So now you've told us that you've had a couple of jobs as a manager. Do you think you would maybe go back into that?
I don't think so now. I think because I've been out of the game working with the BBC over the last 2 years, been away from the game and enjoy what I'm doing just now, so it's difficult, not unless someone came up with a fantastic offer to go and take over at a football club again. So once I get a phone call, I need to consider it.
So have you ever played any pranks on anyone in the dressing room?
Yes, but I can't tell you them.
Okay, well, what's the funniest joke you've been told in the dressing room then?
I can't tell you that either, there's too many sweaty words in it.
Okay, so do you enjoy commentating on matches now?
I do. I think it's great fun. You're turning up there watching the games. Over the last couple of years, I've been mainly at all the Celtic games, so I've been fortunate enough to do all the European games. So you're turning up watching Barcelona, Juventus, and Fiji this year. Every year when you're involved in the European campaign, and then before when the Rangers were involved in the campaign, it was always going to be tough. Used to really look forward to Old Firm games. I must say I've missed them this year. Celtic myself, I'm sure they've missed them because they've lost so many games against the smaller clubs this year. I think that's because they've had no real challenge.
Okay, so last question. Did you have any match day superstitions?
Superstitions? I see every time you're in, you turned up and you get dressed the same way or undressed the same way. You put your strip on, your boots on. I used to go quite far back in the team, maybe go last every day, some of the clubs I played with, and just have things like that. But not too many superstitions. I think that was in the dressing room. Once you got on the pitch, you just went out and played. So you just went out and see what happens. I don't think you had anything where you have to do something daft, pitch the ground, or pitch the post or something like that. I didn't do anything like that.
Okay, well, thank you for your time.
No problem at all. Thank you very much.
Well, from BBC School Report, I'm Ali, signing out.